welcome to our social studies class. In the last class, we studied the Himalayan mountain, then the three parallel ranges. Then these topics we discussed. Then who were the first to climb Mount Everest? Sir Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. Then which is the highest mountain range in the world? The Himalaya is the highest mountain range in the world. Then which is the first or the, which is the highest peak in the world? What is that? Yes, Mount Everest. Where is it? It is in Nepal. Then we studied the three parallel ranges of Himalayas. Which were the three parallel ranges of Himalayas? The Himadri, Greater Himalaya. Then the Middle Himalaya or Himachal. Then the Lesser Himalaya or Shivalik. These were the three parallel ranges. So in this class, we shall continue the three parallel ranges. So let us start the first one. That is the Himadri. The Great Himalaya or Himadri is the largest one. Among the three parallel ranges, the Himadri or Great Himalaya is the largest one. It lies in the extreme north. Then this area is covered with, this Himadri is covered with the ice throughout the, or snow throughout the world. Then the word Himalaya means the house of snow. So look children, take your book, page number 234. The word Himalaya means the house of snow in Sanskrit. In Sanskrit word, the word Himalaya means house of snow. Sanskrit le house of snow ennaana ariyappettunnathu. Nammal kazhinja class le three parallel ranges padichirunnu. Adu Himadri aanu. Then Himadri aanu ayinathu ethavum largest. Pinne adu extreme north aanu. Extreme nu parnjal angiyattam. Angiyattam aanu adinte meaning extreme. So you all of you take page number 235 of the the Himalayan mountains consist of three parallel ranges. They are the Great Himalaya or Himadri, the Middle Himalaya or the Himachal, Lesser Himalaya or Shivalik. Of the three ranges, Great Himalaya is the highest. This is the highest. It lies in the extreme north and is covered with the snow throughout the year. Then glaciers are found in this region. Glaciers means Himanigal. That means Himanigal. മഞ്ഞു ഉരുകി വരും. വന്ന് മലയിലെ ഹിമാലയൻ മൗണ്ടൻസിൽ നിന്നും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മലകളിൽ നിന്നൊക്കെ മഞ്ഞുരുകി ഒഴുകി റിവേഴ്സ് ആയിട്ട് ഫോം ചെയ്യുന്നതാണ് ഗ്ലേഷ്യേഴ്സ്. അപ്പോ ഇവിടെ ഇൻ ദിസ് റീജിയൻ ഓർ ദ ഹിമാദ്രി സോ മെനി ഗ്ലേഷ്യേഴ്സ് ആർ ഫൗണ്ട് ഇൻ ദിസ് റീജിയൻ. ദൻ ആസ് എ റിസൾട്ട് ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് സോ മെനി റിവേഴ്സ് ആർ ഫോംഡ്. Then many rivers like the Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra and Yamuna are formed like this. Clear? Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Yamuna okay? Angane glaciers vadi form cheda rivers aanu. Then the Kanchenjunga and the Annapurna are the two high peaks in this range. Kanchenjunga. Kanchenjunga ennu parayunnathu adhe pole Annapurnayum aanu. Two high peaks, valiya peakal. Peak means kodumudigal. That peaks were that kodumudigal. P-E-A-K-S. Peaks means kodumudigal. So dear children, that in that page itself, next to the Middle Himalaya. Look it. The Middle Himalaya range lies towards the south of the Himadri. Himadri is south lana, Middle Himalaya range. And it is lesser in height. Compared to this, Himadri is lesser in height. And two important ranges here are Pir Panjal and Dauladhar. Dauladhar and Pir Panjal are the two important peaks. Avadathe rendu important. important peaks are Pirupanjalam, Daulagar. And the mountain slopes are covered with in that Himachal or the middle Himalaya, the mountain slopes. Slopes are Chaivugal. Mountain slopes cover pine or tree and tree deodorant. So in the Himachal or middle Himalaya, the mountain slopes are covered with the pine and deodorant. Then hill stations such as Shimla, Mussoorie, Nainital and Darjeeling are situated in this region. Hill stations under Abida Idella E Nainital, then Darjeeling, Mussoorie and Shimla. Iparna hill stations are located in this region. Which region? Middle Himalaya. Clear? So middle Himalaya is lesser than the Himadri or Greater Himalaya. And so many hill stations such as Mussoorie, Nainital, and these hill stations are located here. Then the mountain slopes are covered with the pine and deodar. Pine deodar in the paranya trees are under. Then next range is the Lesser Himalaya. Lesser Himalaya is otherwise called Shivaloka. So we shall move on to the next one, this Lesser Himalaya, and next page number 236. I will read that and explain it. That is, the southernmost range is the Shivalik range. Southernmost range. So the last one is the southernmost one, that is the Shivalik range. It's otherwise called the Lesser Himalaya. Lesser Himalaya is Shivalik range. The southernmost range is the Shivalik range. This range is the lowest in height. This height is very low. Lowest in height. Then the thick forests in this range are and full of wild animals. Thick forest. The thick forest there and this forest is covered with the full of wild animals. This forest is full of wild animals. Then the Shivalik slopes down to merge the foothills of the Himalayas are called Terai region. Shivalik slopes Himalaya foothills. The Shivalik slopes down to merge with the foothills of the Himalayas. Himalayas in the foothills are merged in Shivalik slopes. That is the Terai region. What is that? Terai region. So in the northeast of the Himalayan mountain is the Purvanchal range. So below that page itself, the next paragraph, look children, in the northeast is the Purvanchal range. So what is the name of that parallel range in the northeastern portion? Purvanchal range. And this is a series of low hills. Purvanchal range is a series of low hills. And Purvanchal range is covered with the thick jungles. What do you mean by jungles? Forest. So in the northeast is the Purvanchal range. Northeast of the Himalayan mountain is the Purvanchal range. And it's a series of low hills and covered with the thick forest or thick jungles. And the northeastern hills. The hills in that area includes the Garo, Khasi, then Jaintia, Naga, Lushai and Meso hills. I repeat, the northeastern hills include the Garo, Khasi, Jaintia, Naga, Lushai and Meso hills. And the northwest of the Himalayas, that is beyond the Indus, that is the Karakoram range. Last class we studied the Karakoram range. So the northwest the Himalayas, that is the Karakoram range, that is Mount Godwin Austin or K2 lies in this range. So you underline that sentence. Mount Godwin Austin or K2 lies in this range. And Mount Godwin Austin is the second highest peak in the world. So it is the second highest peak in the world. Mount Godwin Austin. Appo in the northeast lake nammala Purvanchal range aanu padichathu nammal appo. नॉर्थ ईस्ट पूर्वांचल रेंज इट इज अ सीरीज ऑफ लो हिल्स कवर्ड विद अ थिक फॉरेस्ट देन नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न हिल्स इंक्लूड्स गारो कासी जयंतिया नागा लुशाय एंड मिसो हिल्स देन नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न पोर्शन ऑफ द हिमालय इज द काराकोरम रेंज and Mount Godwin Austin or K2 lies in this range. Mount Godwin Austin ee range laana lie cheyyunnathu and Mount Godwin Austin is the second highest peak in the world. This much clear? Okay, then let us move on to the life. What about the life in the region? That is the northern mountain region includes the Jammu and Kashmir, which are the places the northern mountain region includes. That is the northern mountain region includes the Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, northern part of West Bengal, and the northeastern states. So this much portion we discussed. Then the next we shall move on to the life of the Jammu and Kashmir.